Hey there, I'm Mark Harris, CEO of HeroWear. Last year, we launched the HeroWear Apex to change the lives of workers for the better. That driving focus is unchanged. And in the year since we launched, we've made incredible progress. This time last year, we were confident in the science. We knew we had a great product, but we also knew we had a lot of work to do. As many in the wearables industry know, it's one thing to be great on paper or in the lab, but it's something completely different to scale a business, ramp production, and most importantly, achieve real user adoption. In the last year, we've brought our mass manufacturing operation online and shipped Apex exosuits to more than 60 clients at over 100 locations in 10 countries. It's been a big year. We built a dream team of people with deep expertise in biomechanics, product design, implementation, and operations. Each of these individuals has pushed us to learn more and become a better business. Needless to say, we've learned a ton implementing the Apex with our clients over the past year. So we wanted to take a few minutes to catch you up on all the milestones we've passed over the last year and share a few sneak peeks at everything we've learned.
Hey, I'm Paul, Director of Marketing for HeroWear. Much of what we're about to share comes from a series of more than 10 major field studies with workers wearing the Apex daily. These programs are being run with global logistics leaders, major retailers, large construction firms, multiple groups within the US military, and others. These studies are not brief demos for an afternoon or a day, but studies with between 5 and 60 users, each of which runs for 2 to 10 weeks. And many users involved in these pilots and studies refuse to give their Apex back at the end and are still using their suits months later with no interest in giving up their favorite tool. A number of these companies are now also looking to scale up and roll out the Apex more broadly.
And when you're lifting with it, how's that feel?
It helps a lot.
Especially in like certain positions when you go all the way down, you can really feel that stretch and it feel like it's really helping you out.
And, you know, do you want to keep using it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Cool.
At first it was a little, but I done got adapted. Them on uniform.
Yes, I do. It makes my back feel a lot better at the end of the day. My back doesn't hurt near as bad when I get home. I can actually sit down and relax and not have to move around to try to get comfortable.
In order to drive long-term adoption, we knew the three major areas we needed to focus on for these pilots were assistance, no one wants to use an exosuit that doesn't actually help, comfort, no one wants to wear an exosuit that isn't comfortable to wear for long durations, and freedom of movement. Without the ability to move freely and perform normal job tasks, the suit would be left gathering dust in the corner. For assistance, we knew from lab and early field tests that the suit assisted users. It reduces back muscle force around 15 to 25% during lifting and 20 to 40% during bending. Or said more simply, for an average adult, it's offloading 75 pounds of strain off their back for every lift. For warehouse case pickers, this amounts to 100,000 pounds of back relief every day. But would users recognize this assistance? Would it reduce fatigue and muscle discomfort so they could enjoy life once their shift was over? The great news is the answer has been a resounding yes. And best of all, these early results are remarkably consistent and incredibly encouraging. Workers report substantial reductions in fatigue, perceived exertion, and muscle discomfort while wearing the Apex. And this benefit has been sustained over the full duration of every multi-month field study conducted to date.
Hey, I'm Matt Marino, Director of Ergonomics and Human Factors at HeroWear. It's been great to be a part of our early pilots and field studies, to work closely with hundreds of our users and learn so much from them. Just like trying anything new for the first time, using new technology like an exosuit can be hard at first. We understand that. So it's been amazing to be able to live and breathe the experience with our users, see how they've been impacted by the Apex, and continue to use their suits now months later. One example I can share is from the agricultural industry. Workers at farms and nurseries suffer from very high rates of lower back pain. It's hard to describe how much bending, lifting, and just plain brute force is involved in their work. tending livestock, bucking hay, and pretty much every step involved with growing any type of flower, plant, tree, fruit, or vegetable requires bending and lifting. In a recent field study we conducted in collaboration with a large nursery and insurance industry partner, we saw very nice average reductions in ratings of perceived exertion and lifting effort that were maintained over the course of 6 weeks and beyond. Workers also reported significant reductions in work-related discomfort in their lower back, as well as other parts of their bodies, including their shoulders and knees. Many believe the Apex could help prevent lower back injuries for workers across the agricultural industry.
Okay. He said, one of the things that I've noticed that while I've been using it is that I am not as tired at the end of the day like I used to before. When I would get home, I'd be really tired from my back.
It's great to see that results like this are not outliers. Users across all pilots and field studies have reported feeling assisted, with average reductions in perceived effort and exertion. They've also told us how well the Apex fits into their workflow, and how they quickly learn to use it like they do any new tool. They figure out what it's most useful for, and they get into the habit of putting it on at those times. Some workers wear it all day because their job demands it, so they only take it off for occasional breaks. Others have certain times of the day where they throw the suit on to perform moderate to heavy lifting or repetitive bending tasks for just a couple of hours before they rotate to something else where they don't bend or lift at all. Regardless of what they are doing with the Apex or how long they need to wear it, they find it easy to put on and operate. When they wear it, they use the switch to turn on the assistance when they need it. Having the ability to engage, disengage, and adjust the suit helps them take advantage of it when they need it most, but more importantly, it helps them make it as invisible as they possibly can when they don't, so it doesn't get in their way or become a distraction. People are finding the Apex comfortable to wear, and they like having the freedom to move their body and do the job the same way they've always done it. This is just a sneak peek at the data we've gathered so far, and we're looking forward to sharing more in the coming months.
I'm Matthew Yandell, co-founder and chief innovation officer at HeroWear. It's my job to make sure the Apex is the best product it can be. Our partners at Interwoven, who handle the industrial design of the suit, have designed apparel for everyone from NASA to Nike to professional sports teams. We knew that they did an amazing job designing the Apex to be comfortable. They actually won an international award for the design of the suit. It was comfortable to use for hours at a time, but this time last year we hadn't had anyone use it frequently for days or weeks at a time, and there were work scenarios that we just couldn't replicate in the lab. It was great to get such diversity of use in these pilots and learn all that we did. Generally, things went well. Most users reported that the suits were comfortable and said that the minor amount of extra heat retention was not enough to keep them from using the suit. But we did start to hear some consistent feedback on one issue, thigh sleeves slipping. For some users, the thigh sleeves worked great, but the more broadly that we rolled out the Apex across different industries like logistics, construction, manufacturing, and agriculture, the more we encountered a huge variety in the types of pants that people wore and different leg shapes. And for some users, the thigh sleeves would slip down their legs, causing a distraction and requiring readjustment so that they wouldn't interfere with job tasks. We care deeply about end users and their experience with both the Apex and HeroWear. Our goal is to work closely with users and do everything we can to maximize their comfort. A lot of the success of the Apex to date is because of our commitment to getting these little details right, realizing how crucial that functional and comfortable thigh sleeves are to the user experience. We got to work designing a solution, and within 3 days had a functional prototype that eliminated the problem. Our solution is already available for workers that want to use it, and we've begun rolling it out to clients that want it. The cornerstone of our innovation culture at HeroWear is to quickly identify areas for improvement and then rapidly deploy solutions that enhance our users' comfort and overall experience with the Apex. Overall, we're thrilled at the early reception of the Apex, and it's great to see the proof that it is both comfortable and assistive. We are quickly learning where we can improve, and thanks to the modularity of the suit, we're able to move quickly to bring those innovations to life in a way that is easy to implement at little or no cost to our existing users.
Hi, I'm Jennifer, Customer Success Manager for HeroWear. As we said at the top, no matter how assistive or generally comfortable the apex is, if it gets in people's way so they can't do their job, the suit will be left gathering dust. The good news is that when it comes to the user's ability to move freely, the apex is in a class of its own. Not only is the suit made of high-tech textiles that move with the user, with only a few rigid components, but it has an on and off switch that can quickly and easily disengage assistance with one finger in the fraction of a second. And the switch can be operated one-handed, with either hand, even through clothing such as rain slicks, PPE coveralls, and safety vest. It could not be easier to move around in the Apex, from walking across the warehouse floor to operating forklifts, to climbing ladders, or moving in tight spaces. With the Apex, users can customize assistance in two ways. First, thanks to the switch and clutch design, they can easily engage the elastic band at any set point they choose, which means they can easily build slack into the system to adjust assistance for different work tasks. Second, thanks to the suit's modularity, users can choose between two strengths of bands that can easily be swapped out, offering two different levels of support. But there were still users in job tasks that required support with less intensity. So our team is developing a third strength of band to offer even more subtle assistance so our users will have even more flexibility when it comes to adjusting the suit to their needs and preferences. Thanks to our modular design, once they're available, they'll snap right into existing apexes with no tools required.
As you can see, we've come a long way in a year. We couldn't be more grateful for the support of our early adopters, and we're excited to be able to share with you some of what we've learned as we continue to improve the lives of hardworking men and women everywhere. If you're interested in learning more about the HeroWear Apex, you can reach us at HeroWearXO.com.